we came a class further ahead. Like when we started in ninth, you came across linear equations, same, but we also dealt with two variables by drawing a simple graph called straight line corresponding to two variables, then identifying where they intersect. You try to find out the solutions of two variables. And then maybe in 10th class, you have two variables, linear equations. There you have pair of linear equations. Maybe that will be the next chapter that I deal with. First, I'm dealing with another interesting topic, which is also an equation. Now, what is the speciality of this equation is? This is a quadratic equation. Now, before even I further continue with what is exactly quadratic equation, how to get the solutions and all, I just wanted to insist on, in this session particularly, on this session one, day one, what I wanted is, what exactly is the main difference between expression and equation? Because the day we started using the word polynomial, we have been hearing these two words, expression, equation, expression, equation. Now, can somebody give me what is an expression and what is an equation? What is the fundamental difference between expression and equation? Yes, any one of the three. An equation is made up of two expressions connected by an equality sign. Okay. Okay, that's good. So what's an expression then, Manya? Is a number a variable or a combination of numbers? Okay. Okay, first in this session, as I said, we'll try to differentiate between what is an expression and what is an equation. Then we'll also see what is the root of an equation. Obviously, when we define, you will understand root will be existing only for equation. Whereas an expression doesn't have any root. So root will be there for an equation. And then specifically for today's topic, what do we exactly mean by quadratic equation? What is quadratic equation and how to identify it? Then obviously how to solve for a quadratic equation. How to solve and get the roots of this quadratic equation. So first, let's try to understand what is an expression. Yes, as Manya suggested, it's a combination of variable and a number. 3 is a number. X is a variable, isn't it? What are the different mathematical combinations that I can perform on these two, on a variable and a number? Maybe I can add them or I can subtract them. I can multiply them, at the same time I can divide them. When you perform any one of these mathematical operations, yes, other than these we also have exponent, that is also a mathematical operation only. So if we perform any of these mathematical operations on these two quantities, one of them is a constant, one of them is a variable, could be anything, both of them could be variables. But at least one of them should be variable is the condition. Then what I get is, say 3 into x, which operation I performed? I multiplied. This combination, or maybe I'll say 3 by x, which operation I performed? I divided. Or maybe I raised it to the power, exponent, 3 to the power of x. Or I raised variable to the power of constant, that is x cubed. Now, when one of these operations are performed, what we get in mathematics is term. Remember, this was defined in your sixth class. A combination of a variable with one variable with one constant, or two variables but not two constants. 2 square is only a constant number. 2 cube is only a constant number. So when one of them becomes a variable, what I get is a term. Now you collect some more terms. I collected 3 into x, that's a term. 4 x cube, that's a term. If I combine them with either addition or subtraction, that means either I mention this as 3x minus 4x cube or 4x cube plus 3x. What I get is an expression. It's a combination of terms. How are the terms formed? Terms are with multiplication or a division operation or exponent operation of variable and constant. That gives me a term. Combine two or more terms, I get an expression. Right. Expression will have only value because every expression has a variable in it. Suppose I took this expression. Let's make it more clear to us. Suppose I took 3x minus 4x cube as an expression. And I gave you the value x equal to 1. For this value of x equal to 1, I'll get some value for this expression. What will be the expression value? That would be 3 into 1 minus 4 into 1 cube. That is simply 3 minus 4, which is minus 1. So for the value of x equal to 1, my expression value is minus 1. But will it remain same if I take x equal to 2? When I change the value to x equal to 2, the value of this expression would be changing. It now becomes 3 into 2 minus 4 into 2 cube. Now 2 cube is 8. 8 4s are 32 minus 32 plus 6 will give me minus 26. What do you observe here? The expression is taking different values for the different variable values, correct? So expression is basically a variable. And what is controlling the expression? The unknown x in the expression is at changing the value of the expression. 3x minus 4x cube is giving me different values. Once it is giving me minus 1. For some other value, it's giving me minus 26. When I put x equal to 0, I'll get 3 times 0 minus 4 times 0 cube. That is totally 0. So the expression value is changing, correct? So expression is a combination of number, variable, joined together by mathematical operations. Though for the study of up to 10th class, we don't consider exponent as a very specific mathematical operation, but basic mathematical operations are addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Is the meaning and the behavior of expression clear to everyone? Now, what is an equation? We know that expression keeps on taking different values for different inputs. If I put x equal to 1, I'll get a different value. If I put x equal to 0, I'll get a different value. Now, if this expression, 3x minus 4x cube, let's pick up another color to differentiate, otherwise the screen is becoming more clumsy. 3x minus 4x cube expression. And let's consider one more expression. Say 6x. Now this 3x minus 4x cube is an expression. 6x is an expression. If I join these two, when we equate two expressions, what we get is equation. Now the word itself suggests equality of expressions is called equation. Whereas the study part will restrict ourselves to the right hand side being a constant. That means even if this is the kind of equation we have, but we will treat 3x minus 4x cube minus 6x equal to 0. we'll call this term as the equation. This is only for uniformity of. Now again, if you look at this small examples that we have considered here, there is one place where I got 3x minus 4x cube value as 0. For what value of x I got this expression as 0? Can you observe the board and tell me? Others, at least those three who are from the beginning. Yeah, Naren says for x equal to 0, x is what which gave me 0? For x is 0, I got the expression value as 0, right? Then this x equal to 0 is called root of this equation what we wrote here. So if the equation is satisfied by some value of x, then that x is called root. In a coming explanation, I'll take it completely. Now that it's everything on the board, so I'm just showing you. 4x cube equal to minus 1. Now look at this. Is this an equation? First of all, what I wrote on the board, 3x minus 4x cube equal to minus 1. Is this an equation? Okay, Naren, if that is an equation, which value of x is satisfying this equation? I mean, which value of x is giving me this equation? When x equal to 1. So this x equal to 1 is the root of this equation. You can take different values, but for one particular value of 1, the expression is becoming minus 1. Then this x equal to 1 is the root of the expression equated to minus 1. Let's see how the root behaves. Then obviously, what is a quadratic equation and how to solve?